Hey people, welcome to the podcast. Joshua Fields Milburn and Ryan Nicodemus, aka the Minimalists, are in the house dropping truths on how to live better with less. I love these guys. I've known them for years. So much respect for their mission, their work, empowering millions of people all over the world. This conversation is stellar, potentially even life-altering. So with that being said, hit the subscribe button and enjoy. What's up, guys?
What's up?
This is a long time in the making.
Yeah.
It's good to have you here. Great to see both of you.
Stumbling into minimalism allowed us to deal with the thing that had become this priority in our lives. Stuff had become this priority. And so it started with the stuff, but that's sort of the initial bite at the apple, right?
Right.
And then it goes to simplifying all other areas of life.
Right. But there's this moment that you experienced and that you see in the people profiled in the film where the lights kind of go on, like as they begin this process, there's like an enervating that occurs in their lives. Like they become very emotionally involved in the process of decluttering their lives. And it becomes like exciting and there's a momentum that kind of occurs.
Yeah. Yeah. You're talking about the everyday minimalists that we have in our film. Yeah. No, it is encouraging. There's one gentleman in there who talks about how once he started simplifying and got to where he, you know, felt like he wasn't living in a bunch of clutter, he kind of realized like, oh, like I've had everything I ever needed this whole time.
Mm-hmm. And he gets emotional. Yeah. And he's an older guy. He's not like a millennial.
Right. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
No, I love having those kind of everyday minimalists in there to kind of talk about their own personal experiences, especially because, you know, Josh and I, we can tell our stories all day long, but you know, you need other people to resonate with than just, you know, two dudes with really great hair.
Let's talk a little bit more about the movie. I mean, you know, I came into this thinking these guys have been working on this thing for years because I know how long ago it was when I was there at that event. But you are featuring these individuals, the kind of everyday people, minimalist people that are highlighted in the movie. And they're on Zoom calls. So I was like, well, clearly you're executing this project like during the pandemic.
The pandemic was the best and worst thing that happened in this film. So we had this entire day set up in Los Angeles. We had a whole crew booked. We had location and we were bringing, I don't know what it was, 22 or 32 people in to be interviewed that day. The majority of them were these everyday minimalists, right? In fact, I think it was a 2-day shoot. Early or mid-March. Of course, you know what happened.
Right at the beginning, the starting line of the whole thing.
Yeah, but the original thing that we wanted to do was, have you seen YouTube reaction videos when people sort of react to a music video or they react to a product or service or something?
I might have seen one or two
of those. So like we kind of wanted to do that, but with minimalism in a way. Like, and so it was Chris's idea. Chris is our director of photography on the film. And so that actually worked out better by bringing us sort of into their homes in a way. In fact, we had them do some B-roll of some of their houses that shows up in the film as well. So you get to see the sort of decluttering process they went through. Some of them even had footage that they took when they simplified their life, you know, a year or two ago. And we got to include all of that in the film, even though we filmed the rest of it. And
Well, it gives it, in addition to this verite touch, like it's heartwarming because it's so authentic. You know, it's like they're actually shooting it themselves and sharing it as opposed to a sterilized film crew coming in and trying to make everything look just so.
Right. Yeah. We sent them cameras and stuff so it looked like congruent with each one didn't feel like it was out of place. But it was them doing the thing on their own.
Yeah. We got most of the cameras back. Just kidding. We'll get them all back.
So how is it that a guy editing from his laptop in his bedroom was able to get a documentary to trend on Netflix twice? That's what I want to talk about in this video. Spoiler alert, it requires sacrificing your firstborn child and joining a secret cult. Totally worth it, though. earlier this year, my latest film, The Minimalists, Less Is Now, was released to Netflix.
And there it is.
It tells the story of two guys named Josh and Ryan, who after climbing the corporate ladder for a decade, decided to give it all up to live a simple life. The film explores a culture that's become addicted to stuff and the future challenges we face on our pursuit of happiness. And it shows a path towards how to redefine life on your own terms. Once we got through our first few versions of the film, we got back to production. This was around the time that COVID hit, so filming was delayed, but eventually we were able to film 20 remote interviews with everyday minimalists. These were people who had watched the first film and decided to simplify their lives. It gave a richer and more diverse context for how minimalism can be applied to anyone's life. And then we found five experts to help us dig further into the problem and talk about consumer culture as a whole. And after 4 years and three different attempts, we had a film that we were proud of and ready to release. Making this film really taught me that you should never give up on an idea before you've exhausted all options. It would have been easy to settle for good enough, to be okay with a mediocre film and release it independently. But when you really care about the craft, when you truly want to make an impact, there's something deep inside of you that calls you to push forward.
And now you've got your second film out.
Yeah.
Am I right? Is that the second film?
Yeah, it's
the second film. Yeah. And I watched it the other night and it's amazing.
Thank you.
So thanks. Congrats.
Appreciate awesome. That. It was, we thought it was going to take about 4 months to make it. So we started making it right after the first film, which is called Minimalism. But the very things that we bring into our life to sort of increase our well-being actually get in the way of our tranquility. They get in the way of what it means to live a meaningful life. So Ryan in the film has this great line where he said, all the things I brought into my life to make me happy, they weren't doing their job. And I think we recognize that. But then, of course, momentum just sort of propels us forward. And we look in the rear view and all of a sudden we're 20, 30, 40, 50. Michael in the film, 67. We're 70 years into our life and realizing I've been clinging to all of these attachments. And at some point, I want to begin again. Well, that beginning starts with letting go. But letting go isn't something you do. Letting go is something you stop doing. It's the stopping of the clinging. And really, that's what we tried to address in the film.
Stuff.
The accumulation of stuff.
Stuff is contributing to our discontent in so many different ways.
We never really stop to question what is essential, what is necessary, how much of this stuff is actually adding any value to my life.
We have the opportunity to have so much.
Anything that you can think of, you can get on your doorstep now within 24 hours.
That's almost like magic.
What if you removed one material possession from your life each day for a month? What would happen?
I think we should all be allowed to say, you know, I thought this is the life I wanted, but it's not. And so I'm going to start over again.
Our memories are not in our things. Our memories are inside us.
Both of us grew up poor.
Front door here.
We really never had enough.
I tried to fill that void the same way many people do. Chasing the American dream, it cost me so much more than money.
I might have been living the American dream, but it wasn't my dream.
Minimalism changed my life.
It's given me the opportunity to be that person that I used to just talk about being.
This deep knowing that all I was searching for, I already had.
Friends and family have acknowledged a profound change in me.
The reason the message of minimalism is so powerful is because we're binging on all the wrong things and dying of hunger for the things that really matter.